Today, we're installing the new Bedrack system from Rhino-Rack. Stay tuned. And welcome back to another video in the Giveaway Gladiator build series, where we're building this 2020 Stingray Gladiator, and then we're gonna give it away. Now today, we're gonna be adding a little more versatility to the back of the Gladiator, and we're gonna do it by the way of a Rhino-Rack Bedrack system. Now all laid out here on the workbench, it looks like an adult size erector set, so this should be fun. So let's get building. The support legs for the Rhino-Rack Bedrack system bolt right into the factory Mopar cargo rails. Now, if you don't have a Mopar cargo rail system in your Gladiator, they are easy to install. We covered installing this one in our last video. Now, if you have an aftermarket cargo rail system in there, you'll need to check compatibility to see if this kit would work with your rail system. To install the legs, we need to first remove our Mopar cleats. So we're gonna unscrew them and pull them out. Then we're gonna install three of the Rhino-Rack track nuts. And these are a T-nut, and they're gonna slide right in to the Mopar rail. Then we're gonna slip the factory cleats back in place. And then we're gonna slide the remaining three track nuts in. Next up is to bolt the legs in place. We're gonna hold them right up against the bed rail and grab the 30 mil long bolts with the serrated step nuts. And they're gonna sit right into the serrations here. And screw into the track nuts. Now we don't want them super tight, we want them so that they'll just slide up and down the rail. Now we can move to our forward legs. There is a top and a bottom. The top side is almost smooth across the top. The bottom side has much more pronounced indenter, raised area here at the T-slot. So you're gonna wanna turn them with the pronounced T-slot up. And we're gonna grab our single track nuts, slide two in, and then slide them down to the opposite end. We're gonna slide two more in here. And then the same on the other crossbar. Now we want to take our end caps and the little blue key. We can set them in and then lock them in place. Slide the track nuts down along until they line up with the bolt holes from underneath the legs. So now that's one way to do it. Let's try a different way. Now we have left is our longitudinal beams, and we have these end caps, and they're gonna snap right in. And we'll use these long silver bolts to go down inside. Now we'll turn them upside down. Take one of the 20 mil screws, slide it out, and we're gonna take the track nut and just screw it in a few threads. You wanna make sure we have a gap behind it. Now, just like the Pioneer platform we installed over the cab, the Bedrack system is modular, meaning that many of the Rhino-Rack accessories will bolt right in. So that's all there is to installing the Rhino-Rack Bedrack system in a Gladiator. And as you can see, it makes a great mid-height rack. You have plenty of room down below for all your camping gear, coolers, onboard fridges, and up above, lots of room for your adventure toys, no matter what they may be. Whether it be a rooftop tent, kayaks, mountain bikes, you name it. And with all those great tie-downs and accessories that Rhino-Rack offers for their modular racks, you have a way to tie them down. And then if you need to remove the rack, you just have the 3 bolts per mounting leg, and then the rack lifts right out and it frees up the vertical height to haul those bigger items. Now, of course, we have them here at Northridge 4x4. Check the description box down below for a link. You'll also find a link to where you can enter to win this giveaway Gladiator. And then hit that comment section. We'd love to hear from you. What else would you like to see added to the giveaway Gladiator? Thanks for watching our video today. We'll see you again soon.